The Lord says, "Watch, for the time of arrogant assumptions and prideful assertions is over." Trumpet Call of God. March 6, 2005. From the Lord our God and Savior. The word of the Lord spoken to Timothy for all those who have ears to hear. O peoples of the earth, hear the word of the Lord your God. You are lost, drowning in a deep sea of transgression, sinking in the ever-shifting sands of religion and science. You are stuck in the mire of your iniquities, slowly suffocating as the fruits of your labor come full circle to take away your life. For by your own works have you destroyed the garden on account of your greed, have you caused much suffering and death, bringing calamity upon your own heads. Thus, because of your great iniquity, I've drawn back my hand, and for the multitude of your transgressions has the judgment of God come upon you. Dead generation, foolish children, evil surrounds you on every side. Darkness closes in, yet you are unmoved. Detestable birds gather, and predators come forth to stalk you as prey. Yet you see no cause for alarm. Therefore, as I live, says the Lord, surely my flock has become a prey, and my children have made themselves meat for the slaughter. For the peoples of the earth have forsaken me, days without end. They have altogether gone astray. My created ones have removed themselves far from me, and my own beloved have not returned to me, but do always seek their own way. And of the shepherds, they did not go out to search for my flock, but have fed themselves. They did not feed my flock, but have fed themselves. Therefore, hear the word of the Lord, O shepherds, and give ear, all you wayward flocks. For you have surely forsaken the Lord your God. You have surely cast off the cornerstone and broken the bonds. For thus says the Lord, I am against you. All your houses are fallen, and the foundations upon which you have built yourselves up are crumbling beneath your feet. All is dust and ashes, rubble piled up in heaps. Oh, what a bitter thing this is, unending sadness, anguish, and pain. My own beloved have departed from me. My own children have gone far astray. I gave my son for them, that they may live and not die. I laid myself upon the altar, yet they want no part with me as I truly am. They choose death, and with the grave they have made their agreement. Wailing, wailing, tears as a river. No, I will not lose my beloved. Not one of my sheep shall be lost or carried away. I will not forsake my people, nor shall I leave them to be burned in the fire. Thus says the Lord, tremble, O heavens, shake, O earth. Let the seas rage and the mountains crumble before the coming of the Lord. Let the whole earth be bowed down before the Holy One of Israel, for my kingdom comes. Behold, the Almighty is coming down to you. Yes, the Son who wears the full raiment of the Father. For in him alone does my fullness dwell. Thus he shall pluck you from the fire, for he shall scorch the nations with the word of his power, and strike through the wicked with the sword of his mouth. Yes, he shall tread the grapes in the winepress of the wrath of my fury, wiping the wicked from existence, destroying all things which sicken his sheep and cause his flocks to go astray. Behold, he shall destroy utterly all that offends. My people, the Mashiach is your help and your shield. Yahushua, who is called Christ and Jesus, is the rock of your salvation, the one who is and was and is to come. For the Father and the Son are one. Therefore embrace me in my mercy and receive of me in my great love. Come home, O chosen flock, beloved of the shepherd. Come home and abide in your Father's house, for I have indeed prepared a place for you, even from the foundation of the world. Thus says the Lord your Redeemer, I am indeed coming down to shake the heavens and the earth, to move all from its place, to bring forth that which was hidden, and to reveal that which was misplaced, to open that which was shut, and to shut that which was opened. Therefore prepare, my people, for the time is now. Yes, today is the day of salvation. Go forth, my beloved, and set all these crooked paths straight. Regain the line, prepare, and watch. For the leaves of the fig tree are upon its branches. Summer is near. The sun shall soon reach its zenith, and the great day shall rush in. Again I say, watch, for the one who ascended is about to descend. And lo, I am come to accomplish the Father's will, as it's written of me in the volumes of this book. For I have heard the cries of the oppressed, and the groaning of the poor and the needy. I know the plight of the fatherless and the widow. I've tasted their tears, and the heart of the faithful is not hidden from me. Therefore watch and listen also, and be spared, for I am about to give a shout. For all that is written in the book of the Lord, both the former and the latter, comes to pass through me. Take heed therefore, for assuredly I say to you, it shall in no wise come to pass as a mere metaphor or as a parable conceived of by men. For the time of arrogant assumptions and prideful assertions is over. The time of corrupt knowledge and polluted sermons is at an end. For by no other means will these who are left be saved, for they are a very stiff-necked people, a willfully blind and deaf people, a most wicked generation. Behold, the power from on high has come forth to reap and to judge the nations, to sound the trumpet in the four corners, to cause the name of the Lord to resound in all the earth. Bow before the King, therefore, humble yourselves before the Holy One of Israel. Lay yourselves upon the altar and be broken atop this stone, and it shall bear you up. Yet stand defiant, and you shall surely be crushed beneath the weight of the mountain. For I change not, says the Lord.